has been a big jump up that you've seen there. Another thing to keep a note on is that the U.S. crude output also is up by 3% in this year. So that is one number that you would want to keep an eye on. Navneet Damani then joins us with the strategies on that space. Navneet, hi. There has been a lot happening in crude oil prices, which is quite evident in the prices there. What's your sense with nearly 10% up overnight? How much of a further gain are you anticipating?
Hi Manisha, as you mentioned, most of the points that has been covered by the OPEC and probably much of what has been factored out of the meetings. In my previous this thing also, I told that crude oil has shifted range from about $44 to now $53, and until $53 is taken off convincingly, it could have a cap for the very short term, because there are a couple of negative catalysts also at the time being. The move that we've seen is close to 10%, and probably another 1-1.5% could be seen from here on. This would attract buyers, because somebody who's got a left out feeling would like to participate at these levels also. Just in case, for the very short term, we can buy crude on the MCX around 3365, which stops below 3320, targeting 3450 on the upside.
Navneet, the surge in crude oil prices have led to a gain in the metal space as well, and the feeling is that as you see crude prices gain up, the inflation would come back, and that would perhaps lead to gains in precious metals also. But for the near term, what's your sense? The surge in crude oil prices, where do you see another trade being coming in other commodities?
Well, the precious metal seems to be under pressure over the last couple of sessions, or probably the entire week have lost about 10% from the highs seen on the 9th of November. So we would like to stay away from them, because the slide could continue for another couple of percentage more. The other action is in the base metal pack. We've seen most of the metals flying here around, with zinc close to 100% gain year to date and copper about 30% year to date. It still looks attractive, and the space is still attracting some buys. CFTC data shows that the speculative long position are at multi-year high, so there's no kind of reversal seen in the base metal pact as yet. This could attract buying. We would like to buy copper around 398, targeting 404-405 on the upside.
Okay, all right, Manisha, as well as Navneet, thanks very much for joining in and bringing us those commodity strategies. Important news coming in for Apollo Hospitals. It is a subsidiary of the company Apollo Lifestyle.